I had been running so long, every part of my body ached. I couldn't take it anymore. I needed to rest. No, I couldn't stop. I had to keep moving. I was at risk. Risk of being late. For assembly. As soon as I saw Wachowski and Peterson leaving the men's toilet, I knew something was up.
Holy crap, Johnny. Looks like you just had a face-to-face with a typhoon. What happened to you?
They flushed me, man. They freaking flushed me.
I can see that, Johnny. But who did this to you? Who was responsible?
It was Wachowski and Peterson.
But Wachowski and Peterson are just hired muscle. You and I both know that. Who did this to you, Johnny? Who paid them off?
This was bad. Johnny D, aka Johnny the Case, had been flushed. I had to find out who was responsible, who called the hit. So I started with the middlemen, Wachowski and Peterson. Class 10.11, the muscle for hire hangout.
What are you doing here, Vinny? I know it's not to hire someone.
There's been a flushing, and your boys Wachowski and Peterson did the job. I'm here for information. Give me what I want, and I'll leave quietly.
Right, boys? Who wanted Johnny D flushed?
Forget Vinny. We can't tell you nothing.
Wrong answer. Try again.
We ain't gonna talk.
Fine. Have it your way.
The job men wouldn't talk, so I locked them in. I may need them later. Besides, I had a plan B. There was a trio of snitches, more like gossiping bitches. They called themselves the Listeners Union. I guess they thought it was a smart name. Although, they're not a union, and they do more talking than listening. The union consisted of three people. Again, trying to be smart, they used fancy names, based on Shakespeare plays, trying to sound cool. The first and more powerful of the three was Hamlet, the leader of the trio. He pays various snitches around the school to give him information he wants. He's smart, he won't give up information cheaply, and he has a ridiculous vocabulary. Second up was Romeo, an amateur, easy to cheat in deals and rather desperate to look powerful. The third was Juliet. Juliet was as thick as mince. He didn't even realize his alias was a girl's name. He was joined at the hip with Romeo, followed him everywhere. God knows how he got into the trio, as he was effectively a useless source for information.
Vinny!
Deal me in, fellas. I need information.
Presently one of my favorite clients. So, tell me, what is the objective you're currently pursuing?
Sup, Hammy. Johnny D was flushed earlier today. I need to know who called the hit.
Well, information of that magnitude is entitled to a vast price. The deposit will be coming out of an account belonging to you.
I have 50 lunch vouchers. How does that sound?
Sounds good to me.
It is in my best interest that you maintain a high level of silence, Romeo. Please, turn a deaf ear to my associate at the table. The value will be at an increased sum to that of your initial proposal.
Meaning it's not enough?
Precisely.
Okay, I'll try again. Julia, who did it?
Ernica Stone.
Thanks, Julia.
Julia, ain't you insufferable oaf? That was a lot of good business we've just lost. And what the hell are you doing saying that sounds
okay? It's only Vinny, man. It's only Vinny.
Oh, that sounds okay.
But I'm starving.
We need more than that. We need more than that. We can't just survive now.
Well, obviously
how are we gonna
we did
do that?
Get more
now,
than
why
that
would
if
you be
said,
so
yes,
goddamn stupid? What the hell is that?
Is
this expensive with ass? How are we gonna make a bit for some any sort of stuff for that?
Well, you could have just said yes to the lunch tokens.
Well, no, because I wanted more. We're not gonna go for that.
Didn't get more, did you?
Well, we could have got more.
So now I knew Ernie Castone was the man responsible. I didn't know him personally, but I knew of him, which was enough for me to find him.
Vincenzo. I'm glad you could join us.
Join who? Whoa, Johnny, that's one hell of a twist.
That's right, Vincenzo. It was all for you.
Me? What do you want with me?
Well, Vincenzo, you've been a pain in my ass for some time now.
Quit the monologue, Castone. I get it. There's something I've done, and you didn't like it. So you set up this ridiculously elaborate plan to capture me.
Yeah, that's about right. Get him, boys. I said get him, boys.
Who's it you're looking for? Because you know, I'm pretty good at finding people.
Shut your ear, Vinny. Wachowski, Peterson, get your asses out of here.
Oh, them. Well, about that.
You what?
Your boys aren't coming, Case. I mean, Ern. I mean, Johnny. Whoever you really are. Now, can we get this over with? I have somewhere to be.
Screw the headman. I'll take it myself.
Watch your step.
You'll pay for what you've done here, Vincenzo. One day, you'll pay.
Here's the deposit. Sorry, Johnny. I've got to go. I'm late for assembly.
We'll be right back. What are you doing here, Vinny? I know it's not to hire someone,